salty. We've been in Vigo all day. The ship's moved over. We walked around the town, got some great pictures. It's a really pretty town. But your fearless captain forgot to figure out where the buses pick up at to take us back to Sentenzo, where our hotel is for the night. So right now we're desperately trying to find a bus. We've got about 10 minutes left before the bus leaves. I've got a plan. Worry not. Captain Anders, this is Captain Carl. Where are you? You're sick and asleep. Hey man, I'm sorry I called. He's right there in that boat and I just called and woke him up at 11 o'clock. Oops. Yeah, we're lost in Vigo. Captain Carl.
What's his name again?
Vida.
Vida? Vida? Or Vida?
Vida. Bob, no, you have to say it faster, it doesn't work. Bob. He's not going to take my call. Hey, Vida. We're hanging out in Vigo. Are you going to that by chance? Okay. I don't think that was the smartest move. I think he's like, why is Captain Carl calling me? I'm out with real people. We saw two Avian Ambrose shirts go the other way, but we're banking that they're picking us up where they dropped us off. We don't see a bus down here. We're partying until dawn in Vigo. That wasn't our bus. See, the key to any good voyage is a plan. We didn't have a plan. We didn't even look. All right, so nothing panned out. No bus, no rides. So we came to the party. We're at the Guayaba. I don't know. Anyway, apparently it's supposed to go off in here, and these people like to dance. So we'll see how it goes. Yes. We're leaving the Guayaba now. We got our groove on. It's 4 a.m. We're gonna try to find a cheap hotel. We have a friend of a friend that's dragging us around Vigo. Thank you.